Moments of Inspiration, brought to you by the Presbyterian Church of Trinidad and Tobago. It is our prayer that this Presbyterian outreach program inspires you to start this new day with God, who has granted you the gift of today.
Good morning, friends, and welcome to Moments of Inspiration. I'm Reverend Kendrick Suknarain of the Susumachar Pastoral Region of the Presbyterian Church of Trinidad and Tobago, and I feel blessed to be leading you in today's devotion. Thank you for allowing us into your homes this morning as we spend the next 30 minutes in prayer, in praise and worship. For those belonging to the Protestant family, the month of October holds a special day for us when we mark the anniversary of the Reformation that took place in 1518. For the month of October, we will be exploring certain elements of the Reformed tradition, beginning today with the sacrament of Holy Communion. Let us join in prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the day to which you have awakened us, the life that you have given to us once more, and the opportunities that you will bring to us today. Bless us with your Holy Spirit, O God, and give us the heart so that we can move with you today and be blessed by your Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. This morning we are blessed to have a young lady from the Marabella Presbyterian Church with us. Miss Kimberly Polaya is an active member of the youth group, currently serving as president, and she also plays the steel pan with the Marabella Presbyterian Church Steel Orchestra. She starts us off this morning with a summons. Will you come and follow me if I but call your name?
But call your name. Will you is you in me.
Thank you, Kimberly, for setting the tone for our worship today. Now we will share God's word. And God's word comes to us from two portions of scripture. We hear first from 1 Corinthians 11, 23 to 26, where we find these words, "For I have received from the Lord the teaching that I passed on to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the night he was betrayed, took a piece of bread, gave thanks to God, broke it and said, 'This is my body, which is for you. Do this in memory of me.' In the same way, after the supper, he took the cup and said, 'This cup is God's new covenant, sealed with my blood. Whenever you drink it, do so in memory of me.' This means that every time you eat this bread and drink from this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes." And then we also read from Luke's Gospel, chapter 22, verses 19 and 20. "Then he took a piece of bread, gave thanks to God, broke it, and gave it to them, saying, 'This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in memory of me.' In the same way, he gave them the cup after the supper, saying, 'This cup is God's new covenant, sealed with my blood, which is poured out for you.' This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God for his word. Amen." As we reflect on this, let us come to God in prayer. And so, Heavenly Father, we thank you for the opportunity to share your word. And again, we ask that you will bless us by your Holy Spirit so that this word would sink deeply into our hearts. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. So today we share this message with you about Holy Communion. This is something we do every year in the month of October as we ask our congregations to remember and to reflect deeply on this special sacrament as part of our Reformed tradition. At its root, communion is the sign that Christ died for us. He says, "This is my blood, it is shed for you." It directs us to the sacrifice that has been made for us, the price that has been paid for our forgiveness. So if we consider the reading from Luke 22, 19 and 20, where Jesus says, "This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in memory of me." And he also says, "This cup is God's new covenant, sealed with my blood, which is poured out for you." Communion therefore reminds us not only of the fact that Jesus died for us, but it also reminds us of why he died for us. That is, he died so that by his blood, a new covenant can be established and a new covenant can be sealed between humanity and God our Father. And so Jesus is telling us that every time we lift the cup, we partake in this saving blood. This is an expression which is quite common with many Christians, and you find it in many of the hymns that we sing. "Are you washed in the blood? There is power, there is power, there is wonder-working power in the blood of the Lamb." I can remember, too, the other song that says, "What can wash away my sins? Nothing but the blood of Jesus." So communion reminds us of the importance of this sacrifice. It reminds us that the cross is the ultimate liberative event in human history. It reminds us that the old era is gone, and it reminds us that we live in a new era that some people will call the era of grace. Communion is also important to us for a few other reasons. Firstly, for some it is deeply personal, very individual. There are some Christians who will begin their preparation for communion at home, or maybe even from the day before. They will have a period of personal prayer. They may have a period of fasting. It is a time of personal confession as we seek forgiveness from sins. Again, in the words of the hymn writer, at the cross where I first saw the light, we come to God personally reflecting upon our faith, reflecting upon our lives, seeking that God will cleanse our hearts individually and personally at this time. And then, secondly, for us as a Christian family, communion is a very special sign of our being one in Christ. Our Christian faith is not just an I thing, and our relationship in communion emphasizes that. It's not just something which I do personally. It is a we thing. My Christian faith is something which I express with all of the other people who are joined with me at this table. It proclaims that God does not only want us to come as individuals, He gathers us around a table. So He calls us to be a community of believers. He gathers us as His children. Just as a parent would gather the children around the table, so we sit at the table as His loved ones. So this brings us to our third aspect, that here when we meet thirdly as a Christian family, we meet to share this particular moment of grace. You know, it's like the bell has just been rung and we've been called to this table because in this moment something is going to happen. We are going to come in this moment because in this moment Christ meets us here. In this moment Christ is with us. In the moment of communion, we are blessed by the presence of the Holy Spirit. God touches our lives individually and communally. This is a basic belief which we hold in the Reformed tradition. God's Spirit is very active in this moment, not by the physical transformation of the elements, but by the spiritual graces that accompany the elements. So when we meet as a Christian family to share Holy Communion, we meet to share with Christ. Communion is a very special moment since we celebrate not only the present, it is something that we do celebrating the future. We use the word foretaste, a taste beforehand, a taste of what is to come, a taste of what we will experience in its fullness at a later date when we join as one family with God at the heavenly home. It is also important for us to recognize that communion, therefore, has a very strong social perspective. We are all God's children, and we have to also remember that we are all God's children on a tiny planet called Earth, and therefore we have to learn to live together as one community. I want to draw to your attention the closeness of these two words, communion and then the word community. Communion calls us to be a community, to be a family. And in the words of the song, Fashion Me a People, come together in community, a sign of my love here on earth. So, communion and community, these words are important pillars of our faith. Individuality and selfishness are at the opposite end of this spectrum. The more selfish we get, the more impossible it is for us to share real community. The more selfish we get, the more difficult it is for us to live with each other. And so, even if we are to live together as husband and wife, we have to learn how to live in community. We have to forget this selfishness. We have to learn how to think of other people and relate with other people. Communion and community are also very important pillars of law and order in our society. Since we have to learn how to be respectful of other people's presence, and we have to learn how to be respectful of other people's rights. In our family, we have to learn to respect parents, brothers, sisters, uncles, aunts. On the street, we have to learn to respect our neighbors. In the schools, we have to learn to respect our teachers and other students. So when we look deeper into our faith, we have to realize that our faith is not just personal, but this faith, this communion, also calls us to be part of a community of love. It follows then very naturally that Jesus should give us this commandment in John 13:34, that we should love one another. And he says, if we have love for one another, then the world will know that we are his disciples. So, friends, because we believe that we are one family in Christ, we can call each other brother and sister, because when we share this cup of communion with each other, we do so as a family of faith. And it's always wonderful for us to meet and greet each other, especially after long times. Here, let me just take a moment to congratulate our congregation at the village of Kunaripo, where they constructed a new church. And I have not been there for a long time, but it was surely a pleasure to go back there to meet and greet my brothers and sisters with whom I had shared communion in the past. It was a wonderful time to be able to come back and meet them again. And so, friends, let me ask everyone to remember this sense of community during this month. Be a family, loving, kind, and understanding. As members of the Reformed tradition, we celebrate World Communion Sunday on the first Sunday of the month of October, and we as Presbyterians join with other Reformed brethren to remember and celebrate Jesus' call for us to share Holy Communion. We invite you to share communion in your own church. We invite you to share communion with us. Let us join in prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the sacrament of Holy Communion. We thank you that Jesus has given this to us as a sign of his real presence among us. We thank you for the power of the Holy Spirit that touches our lives every time we share in this sacrament of Holy Communion. We thank you for knowing that you are with us. Let us all be blessed with your holy presence. And during this month of October, Lord, we pray that you shall strengthen us to remember to live in community. We ask you, O God, to help us as we share our lives with all others. Lord, we pray that even as we meet people who are outside of our own faith and church, that we shall still be one community with them. So grant us this blessing of communion. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. We have today the talented Miss Liana Dudnath of the Emmanuel Presbyterian Church in La Romaine. She is accompanied by Miss Natalie Pasad Umrao, her fellow teacher from La Prima College. Her song this morning is the inspiring gospel, Testify.
Colors of the rainbow, all the voices of the wind, every dream that reaches out, that reaches out to find where love begins. Every word of every story, every star in every sky, every corner of creation lives to testify. For as long as I shall live, I will testify to love. I'll be a witness in the silences when words are not enough. With every breath I take, I will give thanks to God above. For as long as I shall live, I will testify to love. From the mountains to the valleys, from the rivers to the sea, every hand that reaches out, every hand that reaches out to offer peace, every simple act of mercy, every step to kingdom come, all the hope in every heart will speak what love has done. For as long as I shall live, I will testify to love. I'll be a witness in the silences when words are not enough. With every breath I take, I will give thanks to God above. For as long as I shall live, I will testify. The colors of the rainbow, voices of the wind, the dream that reaches out when love begins. The word of every story, star in every sky, all of creation testify. Mountains to the valleys, rivers to the sea, the hand that reaches out to offer peace, a simple act of mercy to kingdom come, every hour will speak what love has done. The colors of the rainbow, voices of the wind, the dream that reaches out when love begins, the word of every story, star in every sky, all of creation testify. For as long as I shall live, I'll testify. I shall live, I will testify to love. I'll be a witness in the silences when words are not enough. With every breath I take, I will give thanks to God above. For as long as I shall live, I will testify, testify your way, testify your truth, testify your light, your love and mercy. Testify your truth, testify your light, your love and mercy.
Thank you, Liana and Natalie, for your ministry in music today. Friends, we are called not only to pray for ourselves as individuals, but today especially we have issued a call that we should pray for others as members of one family who bear each other's burdens. Therefore, let me ask you to bow with me in prayer. Heavenly Father, we come to you in prayer today for our loved ones, especially those who are far away from us. We thank you O God, for keeping our children, our relatives and our friends, even in faraway places. We lift up before you those students who are away from home and studying. Lord, you know we think about them all of the time. Heavenly Father, we also lift up today all those we know who are in health care. Perhaps they've taken an operation or they are under the care of the doctors. We ask you especially to bless the doctors and nurses in the hospitals. We ask you to touch their heart and to touch their hands. We pray for those who are mourning at this time, all those who today have lost their loved ones and they are grieving. We pray, O God, that you will bless their hearts and bless their spirits. We lift up before you, O God, all of our teachers and all of our schools, young people who are learning, and we ask you to bless them. And we ask you for those who are with us in the workplace. Lord, as we leave our home and journey today, bless all the travelers. Help us that we may treat each other with love and care and understanding. So may we all be one beautiful family today. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Friends, our church offers many activities geared to women, men, youth, children, and family. And in these places, you can develop a good relationship with God. Bisania Bihari will now share some information on these events.
Good morning, Trinidad and Tobago. As we celebrate Reformation in this month of October, we are pleased to offer a special short course on an introduction to Christian worship. The St. Andrews Theological College begins this course on Saturday, 8th October, that's this Saturday, and it will run for 5 sessions. This short course will be led by our moderator, the Right Reverend Annabel Lalaram Kelawan, and anyone who is interested in attending is more than welcome. Remember, this course starts on Saturday, 8th October, from 9 a.m. to 12 noon. Thank you, and back to you, Rev.
Thank you, Sanya. So now we've come to the close of our program today. If you've missed any of our previous episodes, you can find them on our YouTube channel, Presbyterian Church, Trinidad and Tobago. And for any further information, we may be contacted via our website, www.pctt.org.tt. We thank you for joining us in this time of worship, and I would like to invite you to worship with us at any Presbyterian church close to your home. If you are in my area in San Fernando, you are welcome to join our services at Susamacha at 7 a.m. or 5 p.m., Vistabella and Corinth at 8:30 a.m. and Golconda at 10 a.m. Thank you for choosing to start your day with us. My prayer is that you and your loved ones will have a blessed and joyful week ahead. And I leave you with today's moment of inspiration. We are one family, one community in Christ.